First time when I went to my dance school, I was 4 years old, and actually I didn't understand what was happening, because just my mom grabbed my hand and she just made me to do my first training. And since that time, I've been training for, how old am I? I think it's more than 15 years. 15 years, oh my God. When war started, I left Ukraine because I just wanted to save my life. I'm lucky that I had the visa opened and just life called me to come here. I moved to my new room, and it will be my first experience actually living in this kind of room. So I will put lights, and I will put some posters maybe, and I will do this room my energy power place. I don't know, so yes, this is my new place to live. My mom lost her job immediately when war started. I'm very, very lucky that I have ability to work, because I found that I can help by doing some dancing job abroad.
I'm originally from Russia, but left Russia when I was 17. I've been in circus 30 years. Last year we had to battle with COVID, and this year we have to battle with war. So we were thinking that this year going to be better. We had everything ready, everything was set up for the show to open in April. All the artists were booked, all the visas was put into the embassy, and then we had the war. So it's like, I think the life is teaching you to deal with problems all the time. And if you're kind of prepared to deal with problems, you just don't know which problems every day, but if you kind of have this mindset that you have to fix the problems, then you'll be fine.
Yorkshire and North Derbyshire is BBC Radio Sheffield.
So good morning. It's Toby at breakfast. It's BBC Radio Sheffield. Now, an incredible story for you. The Cortex Circus is opening this week in Sheffield. It's a cast made up of brilliantly talented performers, many of whom are from Ukraine. Now, they've all had very different experiences over the last few months, obviously, but perhaps none as difficult as one of the dancers. Morning, Tanya.
Hi.
Thank you very much indeed for being here this morning. So talk us through how that felt then, when one day the Russians are in your country and they're killing people. How did it feel?
Horrible, yeah. So sad. And I still can't believe that it's happening in my country in 21st century. And with my friends, with my family, with me. And sometimes I'm thinking, is it true or am I dreaming now? Mm. But it's still true. And
so then it happened. So did you immediately think, I've got to get out? Was that your first thought?
My first thought was, what should I do because I'm alone? Like, I was alone all the 2 weeks. Mm. And nobody never taught us what we should do. Even if I ask something my mom, she can't give me good advice because she's not in Kharkiv and she has totally different situation because she's living in the center of Ukraine. It was bad, but it was not as bad as in Kharkiv.
When did you decide, this is it, I've got to get out?
After 10 days.
So what did you do?
I caught fifth train at 9 p.m. And I didn't have any seat. Like, I was standing for 15 hours because it was just 1,000 people in train.
Where are you getting food? Are you eating?
No,
this?
I didn't eat. No. And I didn't sleep. Like, I didn't think about it. Mm. I was actually so strong that 10 days and I didn't cry at all. I was like, I was frozen. I didn't feel like very scary and I didn't feel very angry. But when I just stepped on the Hungarian ground, I just sat down on the railway station and I just started to cry because I realized that I'm not in Ukraine anymore.
It's safe.
And yes, it was the hardest moment, I think.
Hard because you'd left the Ukraine, or hard because...
Yes, I didn't. I even didn't say bye-bye to my mom.
I suppose now the thing is, what's the plan? And there is no plan, is there? Because
nobody knows anything. Because when we're listening to our government, like some of them tell that it will end soon.
Yeah.
But it doesn't.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Wowzers! Lovely, Tanya. Thank you. Ooh. You must be shattered.
Hard.
Oh man,
every time when I'm telling this story, I feel that I'm living it again.
Yeah. You were absolutely brilliant on that. You were absolutely brilliant. You told it so well. Bloody hell.
Алло.
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 Привет.
Привет.
Алло.
Ты чуешь меня?
Ну, я Белоречка.
А ты
мне... Как ты, Зазулька?
Ничего, нормально. Ты как... Как твоя рука?
Завтра на 8 годин до лекаря. Ну, болит, дуже болит.
Угу.
А что? Она мне прописала таблетки, я уже их пропила.
Угу.
Але вони мені нічого не допомогли.
А які таблетки?
Ну, від солі. Це, вона казала, що це солі, відложення солі.
Угу.
Читала в інтернеті, що якщо відложення солі, це перший признак старіння.
Та ти що?
Ну, щоб я поділа хвичку і не старіла.
А що, у вас там спокійно в горі?
Так, тільки, ну, вчора дуже бахкали на полігоні, ну, провіряли, чи, ну, ракети, чи вони там, то дуже бахкало на полігоні. Цілий день бахкало.
Угу. А сирени є?
Ну, практично немає.
Угу.
Останній раз була десь 3 дні назад.
А ти що думаєш, що буде з України?
Я думаю, що погано буде.
Угу.
Так, ну, не хочу казати, пишемося.
Угу.
Я рік питаню.
Sometimes I feel guilty that I'm safe and my mom not safe, or my brother, or everyone in Ukraine.
From a war zone to a circus ring. Like most of the Circus Quartet's cast, Tatiana is Ukrainian. She fled the bombing in Kharkiv and traveled for days without food or sleep, determined to get here to Sheffield before opening night.
I decided that I'm going to be killed on third day of war. Just I accepted that it can happen, and I just accepted that. I came to Hungarian border. I was helping people in the train because there were some very bad people, I mean bad feeling, because they came through, like, losing their house or something, or losing their...
You were talking to the other people, yes, and helping them. Shall we... We're going to move the camera slightly. Hold on. I know there's two bits on the wide that I might need to put. So, and obviously we're going to overlay a lot of this, but I need one wide, and then, yeah. With one more shot with Tatiana, then we're done. I know we're holding up rehearsals. Thank you very much. So how old is your brother? Tatiana was excellent.
Yeah.
And you've got a reverse there, and then there's two bits of white put together in a type, but then we'll have stuff to overlay of her anyway.
Yeah. And then yeah, she will be dancing in the yeah, front. You get a shot of her dancing.
Okay, in the rehearsal.
She's our best dancer. She's very good.
Okay.
Is it something you could say?
I'll be explaining in the script where we are.
Yeah, because it's a lot of lesbian here, but we need people coming in so we can all carry on, do you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, no, we'll be making it quite clear with the name of the circus, where you are. Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, that will all be in my script.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
okay,
totally,
okay.
Totally.
In one way, now, it feels like nothing happened, because they're all here, and once you get into this bubble, it feels you've been here forever.
Obviously, they've been through some incredibly tough times. You think that performing can almost somehow help?
Well, to be honest, Tatiana arrived here and she was really, really sad and depressed for about 2-3 weeks. But as soon as she started performing, I could see her coming out of the shell. And you know what? We thought the COVID was bad. Now I was saying bring back COVID, because this is worse. For us, it was a nightmare, it was worse.
And it's that classic thing, the show must go on.
I don't mind to have interviews, but I don't want to give it just to say in the end that actually she is from circus and book our tickets and come to see our show. I don't care, because innocent children and people in Ukraine die. I just want everyone to hear that it's not just a picture from the news that is happening, that just the real story that ruined hundreds of thousands of lives. Sometimes I feel that I'm too empty inside, and it would be difficult to give some emotions and expressions on the stage. But because I'm professional, I can do it.
people are buying tickets to come to see the happy faces on stage. They don't want to see anyone upset or sad stories.
To win the prize, you must take as many photos and videos of the show as you can and then post them online whilst tagging us at Circus Cortex UK on Facebook and Instagram. The best photo will win a prize.
Dancing is the thing that I want to do as much as I can, as long as I can. I was always dreaming about big, huge stage with lots of professional lights and with the decorations and with very expensive and nice costumes and very big, famous show, full house every day. I've never thought that I can be in such situation. And yes, I stuck here for 5 months. But I need to face everything that come into my life and I just need to do it.
But it has to be postponed till now, as the majority of our cast here are from Ukraine.